lose.
I can't fix each and all your problems. I'm no good with naked faces. She sent me naked pictures from a neck down to the waist. I get my feelings involved. She stopped returning my calls. The flaws turning to walls and barricades.
And Eloise can't pay for public transport.
Four ways and every long day is a bad one. I can't make you.
Well, I heard you might have found somebody new. I still can't swallow it.
I'll be
hella. And I went out tonight. Shit don't feel the same.
Hi guys, I'm in Rome and I'm literally not having a good time.
We're not having a good time.
Eloise just paid £5 for this gelato.
And I was like, what the fuck? £5? He was like, yes ma'am, only €5. So good.
Good price for you. I was like, no, actually, it's literally like the worst price I've ever seen in my whole fucking life. Anyway, look at this monument. That's a garden. We tried to go into the gardens and it was €16, unless you were aged between 18 and 25. And we were like, oh my God, this is perfect. But you have to be in the EU with a form of ID, which is kind of like, also we were going to go into the Colosseum. Honestly, I don't know.
They wanted to charge us £50.
It was like £55 as well. To go into the Colosseum, which, like, you didn't even build it. I'm pretty sure it was built by slave labor. Where's the profit going? And aristocrat people, there's loads of like horse and carts here, and this one guy had his horse and cart in the sun, just stood there. And I was like, in Italian, I was like, is your horse not hot, mate? And he was like, I'm in a jumper. And I was like, yeah, but he's pulling around a family of six every half an hour. And he goes, well, you work, we work, you're walking around in this heat. And I was like, yeah, but I'm not working. And he went, you're lucky, bitch. And I was like, just fucking park your horse in the shade. He's literally, like, it just made me really sad. Oh yeah, I get that we're in a city, I get that. And I think this has really helped me further my knowledge that I'm not a city girl. But how many times do you have to beep your horn? I've never been somewhere with
it's
more
so
horn
aggressive.
Beeping.
It's so aggressive.
It's like anger.
Anger, I hate my life.
Do you want to know, in the last 10 minutes, how many times I've been asked if I want to go on the hop-on, hop-off bus tour? I don't want to fucking do it. And I've just started coming up with, like, after you walk down the street, I'm not even exaggerating, it sounds like I'm exaggerating, but as you're walking down the street, every 10 seconds, someone will try and sell you something. I get it, we're in a city.
Sunglasses, hats, paintings, trips,
portable chargers,
tours.
Bottles of water, like, everything. And I know we're in a city, but I'm still allowed to complain about it, because that's how it is in the city, does not mean it's good. Honest review of Rome. 3 out of 10, because like, look, this is
there,
like,
are gorgeous views, and the gorgeous view is that, but I want to go there.
We can't go in. This is the lovely bit of grass that we get to visit for free, and then past this little fence there's a lovely green bit of grass which is like got wildflowers planted in it, and this archaeological bit, but we can't go in that because you have to pay. I mean, we could go in it and pay, but like, out of my morals, I don't think you should have to pay for grass, in the same way that I don't think you should have to pay for water. But yeah, I've started coming up with really like good excuses for when people try and sell me stuff now. Miss electrical charger, I'm scared I don't use electricity.
Scared of heights.
Yeah. Miss water, I have a phobia of water. Yeah, I'm scared of heights. I can't go on your hop on, hop off bus. I've got rabies. But yeah, so I think what we're gonna do now is, we've still got like 2 full days here, so I think, and then half a day, so we're just gonna plan day trips to get the fuck out of Rome. I actually do have a really good flea market haul though, of some really nice stuff, sneak peek, it's really good. But oh my God, and also the Airbnb lady is like the strictest woman ever.
Oh my God,
her
absolute silence after 9:30.
Her caption on Airbnb was like, if you don't move around the world will move around you. I'm a traveler and I love travelers. We're gonna have the best time, guys. So we were like, sick, booked, book it. She sends us a message going, after 9:30 p.m. absolute fucking silence,
don't
but you can
the,
fuck
don't
off.
Don't use the oven or the washer.
Yeah, full access
no
to
Wi-Fi,
kitchen.
No hot water. I don't have to look after any of your belongings.
Yeah, it was like full access to kitchen, no oven, no hot water, no dishwasher. No, not dishwasher, clothes washer. And it's just like calm. Okay, I don't expect a clothes washer everywhere we go, but like it's one of those things where it's like it would have been nice.
We're literally paying for a bed.
We are. We're paying for a double bed in a room of 15 other people.
£45.
Yar.
Not happy.
We just want to get out of Rome.
Get me out. You wanted my number.
I know. This building, does this not scream Nazi, like the eagle and then the pure Aryan face, like,
and the eagles,
look at it under the red light as well.
That looks even worse. Imagine this Hitler is just standing up there and going, everybody, yo, listen, what's good.
He just got bust out into Eminem rap. Hey guys, we're literally having the worst time ever.
We are literally gonna move our accommodation because we are so upset in this place. So, Megan was upset and then I was like, I fucked,
she was like
the directions.
Don't be upset.
And then I started crying. Worst time ever.
So we don't like Rome and we don't like our accommodation.
But I feel like it's partly the accommodation.
Yeah, but we also can't change Rome. But we can change the accommodation.
Yeah.
So I think, guys, look, we're on a budget. I think we're
on a budget.
I think we're gonna break the budget.
Yeah.
And get a nice hotel.
Because I can't stand this anymore. We're gonna do tonight.
The lady last night was snoring her asshole off.
Megan was listening to classical music.
I woke up at like 1 and I was like, and I had to go get my earbuds because I left my fucking headphones in London. So I had to get my shitty airport earbuds.
Oh,
also,
God.
We just spoke to our favourite receptionist at our first hotel and told him our life is shit. Also, he asked Eloise on a date.
Asked me on a date and I said,
I have a boyfriend.
Thank you very much, but I have a boyfriend. You're lovely though.
Oh, also, it's 10 p.m, we've not eaten. What time do they serve food till here?
Probably like... I'm hungry.
I'm in Rome, in a new accommodation, because we could no longer tolerate the Airbnb that we were in. We don't like Rome and we didn't like the accommodation. Can't change Rome, can't change the flights. Only thing we could change was the accommodation. So we've moved into a small hotel room. I don't really like Rome because it's a city, but I didn't think that that would be a problem because I do like places like London. It's just really depressing here. I don't know who's romanticized this, but it's not for me.
There's amenities.
It smells nice. Look at all these.
Oh my gosh, look at this. We could probably keep them as well. Finally.
Many people, really drunk.
Really fucking drunk.
What?
Going home.
Fuck. I hate Rome.
I love Rome.
Where are we right now? Where are we?
With this policeman.
Trastevere. We love Trastevere.
Trastevere.
Muy bueno.
Muy bueno.
Muy.
Trastevere.
Tre bella. Tua bella. I've literally never been this hungover in my life. I'm like manual breathing.
I was a mess this morning. Can't do it anymore.
What?
I need some time.
What did you do this morning? Say it again. She.
Oh my god.
She vomited.
Vomited. C.
She TC'd.
Yeah.
Should we just like fucking go?
You fucking go.
But yeah, I've never been this hungover. And we were like, why are we so hungover? Because yesterday.
Now Megan added up how much we drank.
It was crazy. I'll insert a screenshot, but I feel like a disgusting scoundrel. Because this lady. Is that it? No. This lady gave us 2-3 litres of red wine, 0.5 litres of red wine. We'd already had 1 litre of white wine, and then we bought our own another 0.5 litre of red wine. It's just too much. I just can't. I just can't take it anymore.
Can't do it anymore.
And we're travelling from Rome to the next Airbnb. And it's all just getting too much.
Welcome, welcome, welcome to our apartment.
Wow. I'm just repacking some stuff. We're heading off to Copenhagen today. Check out at 11, it's literally 10:30. I do wanna go slow, but in the best way possible. I'm just gonna repack some stuff and sort some stuff to post back to England because why do I have so much stuff? But I wanted to start with a little preface because we didn't entirely enjoy our trip. Now, I wanted to start it because I think some of the bits where I'm speaking in this video, I'm quite negative about Rome. I'm very much like, I hate Rome, get me out of here, like fucking get me out of here. And we really didn't like it, and we did end up changing our trip last minute so that we could end up doing one of our 3 or 4 days in Rome in Ostiens, which is just outside of Rome because we just couldn't do it anymore. I didn't really explain in this video why we didn't enjoy it. I didn't want to do a whole video being like, I don't like Rome, I don't like Rome, and then just never say why. So I think in the video I say a lot like, oh, it's a city and I don't really like cities, which is true, but I also think my anxiety was playing up at the time as well, and being in a busy city really didn't help with that. So that's nothing to do with Rome, that was on me. But it did affect my experience. I thought Rome itself was really, really beautiful. Like all of the monuments, everything. The city was completely gorgeous. But I really struggled with my experience of the city. So you'll see in the video, we had some issues with accommodation. We really struggled getting accommodation for Rome. It was just difficult to do on a budget. So we spent one night in a hostel and then couldn't stay in that hostel. It ended up being booked. Can't remember exactly what happened, but didn't end up staying in that hostel the entire time. We ended up moving to an Airbnb. Now, we didn't think this would be an issue because the Airbnb was only 20 minutes outside of the city, but it actually made all the difference. Like, getting in and out of town just became quite difficult. Like, getting the bus, which showed up every hour, was a bit inconvenient. You can't just, it's a big city and you're doing a lot of walking, and it was so hot. We were there in early April, okay, and it was like 27 degrees. On some days it was like 33 degrees, and to not be able to go home or anywhere during that is a bit difficult, especially as you can only bring a little bottle of water with you. I definitely recommend getting accommodation in the center of the city. And then we had other problems with that Airbnb where we were told that we'd be staying in like a double bed in a shared dorm with 15. It was not a shared dorm. It was like someone's gaff. It was someone's gaff. We were staying in this lady's gaff, but she'd managed to somehow fit enough beds to fit like 10 to 15 people in one room, and it probably was like roughly the same size as my bedroom now, and so it was just uncomfortable. Like, I say some other stuff about the place in the video. It was just like, for what we were paying, we weren't paying a lot. I think we paid like maybe £40 a night, and between us that's £20 each, and it was just like we were like stacked on top of each other. It was just so weird and so bad, and like, it was such strange vibes. I feel like I sound like I'm a budget traveller. I will just do whatever I can. Like, I'm going to Spain in a few months and I'm going flying to France just to get a 10-hour coach to Spain because I want to save money. I don't mind about doing weird things to save money. Such strange vibes, okay? It wasn't for me, and I think that also affected my experience. Another issue I had with the city was, like most big cities, there's a lot of homelessness. If you went to the train station at night, you had about, like, I sound like I'm exaggerating, between 30 and 50 people lined up outside of the train station asleep, like just rough sleeping. But actually seeing the density of the homeless population was heartbreaking, to be honest. I also really struggled with the normalization of catcalling. It's not normal and it's fucking terrifying. Like, me and Eloise would be walking down the street, we'd get catcalled, we'd go to cross the road, this car would just like pull back, turn around and follow us crossing down the opposite way where it wasn't even going. If you were like walking along, you'd get catcalled, the lights would go red, fuck, now I'm stuck with this car who's catcalled me, rolling their windows out going, come on girls, get in our car, get in our car. I don't want to, I want to go home, actually, I want to go home. Fuck off. Fuck off. It's not flirting, it shouldn't be normalised as flirting. It's unprovoked and it's unconsensual and it's horrible, and I really, it made me uncomfortable when I was already anxious and upset and it was just overwhelming. Okay, I get we're in a big city. I say it again, we're in a big city, okay? Did you know we're in a city? We're in a fucking city. Did you know we're in Rome? We're in a big city, okay? Everything was like really expensive. Like the food was cheap-ish. Colosseum was £50, top tip, Colosseum's free. The first Sunday of every month, I think. So go then. Anyway, I also want to say, when we ended up going to Ostiens, it was lovely. It's fine. You know, it's nothing special. There's nothing crazy to do there because it's just where the locals go to go for a swim. So there was nothing really crazy to do, but I think we really needed that recovery time. I'm not going to lie. It's close to the airport as well, so it's quite convenient if you have a flight that gets in sort of late evening time, just to go there, spend a night there, and then move on into Rome, or the other way around, which is what we did. But overall, like, I think I gave quite a negative review of Rome, and I think Rome as a city itself was incredible, but my experience of Rome was tainted. Oh, I also forgot to film an ending, so this is my ending.
Doing a happy dance, doing a happy dance, doing a happy dance.